These guys, they are one of television's most talented and attractive couples. Rob Mills and Georgie Tunney are bringing the fashion and fun to this year's Melbourne Cup Carnival as hosts at the Birdcage, and they join us now trackside. Hello, you two.
Hi, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So hot right now.
That is a good suit for a Monday morning, can I just say
thank
as well.
Thank you, thank you. Well, I was listening to Victoria before and she was talking about dopamine dressing, mm-hmm. and I feel like I've nailed the brief. However, when I was talking to Tristan and Robert before, they reminded me it's Halloween, so I've actually rocked up as a pumpkin.
No!
Yeah, we're going trick-or-treating after this. The professor and the pumpkin.
Yeah. Yeah. So here we are. Yeah. Here we are.
Now, first thing, so you both looked sensational on Derby Day. How was it?
Oh, it was so much fun. I had a ball. It was like our first time working together, though. Yeah. And I have to say, I think Robert was probably more nervous than me. Is that fair?
Well, professionally, that's what you do as a job. You talk on camera all the time. You're usually being interviewed. So I'm interviewing a bunch of people. I got to interview Jock from MasterChef, Tim McDonald from The Cheap Seats. I actually got dragged into singing on stage at the Penfolds Marquee with my mate Mikey. He's like, yeah, here's a microphone. So that was...
You got dragged. Yeah. I know.
It was like a Ron Burgundy moment.
Yeah, I really have a bed.
Yeah, but when we came here, it was like, oh, how good were those golf buggies just, like, driving us around the track on Saturday? And I was like, I didn't get one of them. I was ready to chop my own feet off because my heels were so... I was so sore just walking back and forth to the mountain yard the whole day.
Stay close to Ange Bishop. That's what we do. We just always jump on the back there. But, yeah, both of you got to present on air as well over the weekend. Did you actually get a chance to enjoy the festivities? Because you're always so... I mean, you're so great. That's why you're so busy on this all the time.
Yeah, I think so. Like, I usually have a nice mix. Like, last year I was in the stables with the horses and with all the trainers and things like that. And so I still get to go down to the mounting yard as well and you feel a bit more amongst it and you can see all the beautiful horses and things, which I love too. Yeah. But, yeah, we did. We got to have plenty of chat.
Oh, mate, I had a few bets. I had to put a few trifectas on. Did not get any. Got a few winners, but they were in the trifectas, so I didn't get them all. But do you know what I love about this year? The Birdcage is reimagined and especially for the Paramount Marquee here. So we're so lucky.
Great, isn't it?
We can see the track. The last few years, obviously, no Birdcage at all. Before that, you're literally in these little shipping containers, fancy shipping containers, but you couldn't see any of the races. This year, there's a few marquees like Furphy and Mum and Lexus, I think, and even here. I was at the Penfolds, also could see the race. It's so much fun to be here.
So and also, if you have people here back as well.
Yeah,
for sure.
I think, yeah.
And live music, everywhere.
Yeah. All eyes are on you.
I was going to say, you hit all the big sponsors' names, names for your wedding.
I'm on the door. I'm on the door for all those ones.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Tomorrow, of course, is the big day, Lexus Melbourne Cup. The forecast, though, George, is looking shocking.
It's not looking great. It's not looking great. If I can recommend for people at home, if you are coming to the race tomorrow, maybe pack something warm, pack some flats if you can, and pack some Telfer. Faster Clarentine because I've got terrible hay fever. Mm-hmm. But look, it's even if it does rain, it's going to be great because the people are back, the racing will be amazing. I'm excited to see how the horses go in the rain as well, and that might just even out the field again.
Yeah, super
a little
soft
bit.
Track.
Yeah.
Who's your tip?
I'm going for Smoke and Romans because Jamie Carr's riding. It's a Kieran Maher horse.
And I love I really, really love a pun. So there's a horse called High Emotion, but it's spelled E-M-O-C-E-A-N, High Emotion. And there could be a bit of water rising up, so High Emotion.
What made you pick that horse? Was it the lovely silks or something the jockey was wearing?
The pun, the silks, also I really like the colours, yes. I'm not very
technical. Technical. We're usually the one I'm like, oh, who are you going to bet on? And I was like, I have a feeling about number two. Punt is worse.
Got to ask about the wedding.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. I was going to ask about the project.
No,
yeah, that's the wedding. Is that the biggest punch you're taking? Oh, no. How are the plans going for the wedding, of course?
Oh, babe, how are the plans going?
What plans?
Yeah.
The only plans we've made so far is that we're going to have a wedding someday. Also, I got a ring from Georgie. So I gave her a ring when I proposed, but she brought back a ring from Bali that she had handmade me. Aww. So I thought that was very lovely. And
I'm very cute like that.
She's very cute. She asked me to marry her. And I said, no. No, I said, yes, it is.
I feel like you would be a bride chiller.
Yes.
And you would be a groomzilla. And I say that with great love, Bob Mills.
Yeah.
We haven't made any plans yet, if there's any wedding plans.
No, but I would agree with that in certain ways because we're both terrible planners. But I'll be like, oh, we'll just figure it out, maybe this. And he's like, well, no, we should probably have, like, a scheme and, like, this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But, yeah, whereas I'm like, whatever.
See, this is a chief in action. Look at the way you two
look at each
other.
The most important thing is you're both happy together. The lovely share between each other is that you can see it, can't you? It's beautiful.
And you are doing a bang-up job on the project. You've been interviewing huge stars from Idris Elba to the Kardashians. Yeah. Any favourites?
Oh, I have to say, most recently, I loved chatting to Jamie Lee Curtis. Really exciting, yeah, because I was a massive fan of True Lies growing up, and it was her final foray into the Halloween franchise, again, dressed as a pumpkin. But she was so great and super open, and she was really emotional about the role. And I love... That's what I really like. I like when you... Because you only got seconds when you're talking to people in a junket, but when you, if you can actually build a connection with them, it's really fun.
Are we going to see more of you on the desk next year, maybe?
Possibly.
Will we be seeing more of you on the desk next year?
I've got a morning show to host. I've got hours to fill. Rob and Georgie.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah, you're the best. Have the best day tomorrow.
Thank you.
It's always been fun.
Happy punting, drink and gamble responsibly.
Yeah. Thank you.
There we go.